Hi there, welcome to Be a Surface Pro. Today's Surface Pro tip is use Snip and Sketch. In the last couple of Windows updates, Microsoft have been pushing out a message inside the snipping tool saying that we should use the Snip and Sketch tool instead. A lot of people are annoyed about this because Snipping Tool has been in Windows since Windows 7 and it's been a fantastic tool for taking screenshots, especially if you had a device like the Surface with a pen, because you can mark up over the top of those screenshots. But now, Windows wants us to use a different tool, Snip and Sketch. So let's have a look at the advantages of this new tool and see whether we should use it or not. One of the first things that you'll notice is it's quite built into Windows 10. For example, if you have a look at the Action Center here, you'll find that you can actually activate the Snip and Sketch tool from the Action Center. You can also activate it with your Surface Pen, and by default, it's actually programmed in so that if you double-click your Surface Pen, it will take a screenshot with the Snip and Sketch tool. And you can change the settings of the Snip and Sketch tool so that it activates when you hit the print screen button on your keyboard. And that way, you'll actually see the screen snip so that you can edit it and change it rather than it just going as a photo into your screenshots folder on your PC. Another advantage of the Snip and Sketch tool is that it automatically copies your screen capture to the clipboard, meaning that you can just paste it into another program. So for example, I could take a screenshot and paste it straight into an email. Another good thing about Snip and Sketch is that you can have multiple windows open. So I could be working on 3 or 4 screenshots at the same time and just move between them. That's something that I couldn't have done with the snipping tool previously. Another thing that I loved about the snipping tool that is now in the Snip and Sketch tool is being able to put a border around your screenshot. But here in Snip and Sketch, there's far more options for that border. So I've got lots of different colors to choose from, and I can make my borders thinner or thicker, which is something that we couldn't really control much in the old snipping tool. Some of the features of the snipping tool have come straight across into Snip and Sketch. For example, we have the same window modes. We have a full desktop capture. We have a specific window capture mode. We also have the ability to mask the screen and just capture a specific portion, or we can use a freeform lasso selection tool to capture our screenshots. We also have the delay mode that we had in the snipping tool, although we have a few less options for this one. You have the ability to take a new screenshot in 3 or 10 seconds in Snip and Sketch. This allows us to set the screen up just like we want it. Sometimes when we take a screenshot with other tools, our right-click menu that we might have brought up, for example, might disappear when we actually take the screenshot. And this delay mode allows us to set the screen up exactly how we want it to be, and it gives us a bit of time to do that. Another thing that's been really improved in Snip and Sketch is the pen experience. We've now got pens, pencils, and highlighters, and we can actually adjust the color and thickness of the line very easily. You'll find that the pen experience is one of the best. It's very fast to respond to the Surface Pen. It also has that tilt sensitivity built into the pencil tool so that you can use that on your screen captures. You'll find extra tools in here that could be quite handy, like the ruler and the protractor mode as well. Now, of course, there's lots of other screenshot tools that are available for Windows users, and we did a separate video on screenshot tools for the Surface Pro. We'll put a link to that in our description. But tell us about what you use Snip and Sketch or the snipping tool for, or maybe one of those other screenshot tools in the comments below. Remember to like our video and subscribe to our channel, remembering to hit the bell so that you get notifications about upcoming videos like this one. Today's Surface Pro tip is use the snipping tool, saying that we should use Snip and Sketch instead. Now the snip and